three friends in the last month developed breast cancer. Could we have been there?
This is kind of exciting.
When you look at the Internet of Everything, what we can do is to put sensors on a woman's body.
Much more comfortable than a mammogram, isn't it?
Communicate abnormalities to a very smart data center and get feedback on their health within minutes.
Wow, Detected is a documentary that follows the efforts of Rob Royer and his startup that developed a bra that can detect breast cancer early, and it's going to be screened tomorrow in Beverly Hills, and he joins us now along with filmmaker Seth Kramer. Thank you so much for joining us, and I don't know if you gentlemen know, but I am a breast cancer survivor. Mm-hmm. I was diagnosed in October, and so this has certainly caught my attention, and I think really the attention of everyone, because breast cancer is affecting so many women. So tell me, how did you come up with this idea?
I'd love to say I came up with the idea. I didn't. There were some really bright physicians and physicists back in the late 1980s and early 1990s that started this technology that they thought we could look at change over time on breast tissue and maybe compare it to what are called circadian patterns and had a physician apply this in a hospital.
Okay. And so how often then would the woman have to put on the bra?
Well, what my job was is to figure out how to scale that technology and get it out to what we call population health so that the woman can screen in the privacy of her own home.
Oh, okay.
That was the major shift in why I came aboard.
Okay.
So now every 2 hours is when you can scan for a 2-hour time period, and we're, as it's recommended, once a month you check your own breast health.
Okay. And then why was there a need to then document this whole process, Seth?
Oh God, this is a story that's like a documentary filmmaker's dream. As Rob and I were entering the building today to see you, we talked to the security guards. They were like, why are you here? Oh, this guy just made an internet-connected bra that can detect breast cancer. And they were filled with questions, like, how does that work? You know, why is it needed? You know, it's just, it's a fascinating story. And once you hear it, you know more about the way the world works than you did previous. It's just, it's eye-opening and it's a fascinating tale, and I wanted to amplify the work that, Rob is doing.
How soon could we really see this, you know, in our lingerie drawer, so to speak? Yeah.
So knowing it's taken at least 15 years to get to this point in millions of dollars, I'm happy to say by early next year, by first quarter, we will be in market. So we're launching mostly through Asia and then coming into the United States in 2018.
Okay.
So yes, at that time, in your closet or wherever you have it. That's
And we would just go to our doctors to get these? How would that work?
The main source is going to be through your, family practitioners and OBGYNs, right? But over time, it will also have the ability to go over the counter, which is what we've heard from women is really what they'd like to do, is to be able to get this on an ongoing basis from their pharmacy, for instance.
Wow, and so it'll be a little more comfortable for those screenings as well.
Right, it just goes under your normal garments today. It's not part of fabric, it just goes under your normal garment. And the information then is processed into the cloud for some really smart algorithms and some great engineers in the back end to do calculations to come back. And then they can either tell you that you're fine, or they might say you may want to see your physician, or the smartphone may also allow you to have your physician notified at the same time.
Wow, and so then this would more or less be the initial screening, then you would go and then maybe do some traditional screening, or that would be it, you
think? No, really important. You never bypass the physician's request, and you make sure you get in to see the physician, because this is a monitoring event. It's quite accurate, which is great to hear that we can do that. But most importantly, always go back to that physician and make sure that you're getting the regular checkup that's required, and then they can hopefully treat earlier. That's what this is all about.
Really?
Screening in the home, hopefully getting an earlier diagnosis versus what might be 8 or 10 years by the time you can actually visualize a normal cancer.
Wow. So earlier, which is always key.
Pretty critical.
Yes, right? Absolutely.
Higher and survival.
Yes. It is really remarkable that you could just do something like this and detect it right at home before you even head into the doctor's office.
That's the objective.
Yeah. And so a lot more people will be able to learn about this through this documentary that's coming out.
Yeah, I have to tell you, you know, when I first asked Rob if he would agree to have cameras follow him. Mm-hmm. I had no idea how you make such a device.
Mm-hmm. I said absolutely not, by the way. No way. Too much going on. Right? Mm-hmm.
I used a Jedi mind trick, and he finally relented. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I was, do you make it in a garage? Like, what happened? Mm-hmm. So it turns out, you know, Rob traveled all over the world, mm-hmm. Combining a team of experts in breast health, in internet technology, because it's an internet-enabled device, mm-hmm. The financial sector, to help lift this off the ground. So following him, mm-hmm. I mean, it's such an eye-opening story. Mm-hmm. It was a real learning experience,
yeah.
You know, so people will enjoy it.
The only reason why we finally, frankly said we're finally going to do this is that we also heard that there was this tiny little company called Cisco, yeah. out mm-hmm. of Silicon Valley,
yeah.
who was very interested in seeing the shift of time, where people wear Fitbits today and maybe after six weeks you put it into your drawer and you know mm-hmm. what you have, mm-hmm. from the wellness side. So you go from fitness to wellness, and the wearable device market shifts completely into something that's a sustainable healthcare advantage.
And the fact that Cisco's on board is pretty remarkable, because there's really nothing linking them to this, correct?
Right. Well, right. Cisco, the internet technology mm-hmm. company, they don't have a financial stake in the okay. work that Rob is doing.
Okay.
So I was thinking, well, maybe they won't want to fund this documentary. Mm-hmm. But their interest in the documentary mm-hmm. is in that it shows the internet being used in a way that we don't normally. Okay. You know, we sit mm-hmm. here, we text, mm-hmm. we upload, you know, selfies.
Yeah.
We don't use the internet, most of us, to screen for breast cancer.
Yeah.
So the documentary shows a new direction that internet technology mm-hmm. is heading in, and that was very exciting for Cisco.
Yeah, and the film actually came out in April, debuted in April, but there was a screening in Beverly Hills tomorrow, mm-hmm. and that is at the
Aurora Fine Arts Theater.
Perfect.
Fine Arts, Lemley Theater.
Okay.
Santa Monica.
Okay, perfect. And you can get certainly much more information and tickets
On their website.
And we're going to link everybody to our website, which is kcal9.com. Click Scene on TV, and they can get all of the information right there.
We'll be
right back. Perfect.
Thanks, Amy.
Thank you so much.